What's going on, y'all? So we back again for another episode review of Power Book 4 Force. Okay, this season 2, episode 3, War Ice Cream. Girl, I ain't gonna lie to you, this episode didn't really do much for me. It kept me, but it still didn't do much. Basically, Tommy, you know what? I know we supposed to be rooting for Tommy, but sometimes Tommy just gets on my nerves because he's so gung-ho about stuff, and he just wants stuff to happen right then and there the way that he wants it, how he wants it, no matter what. And I feel like that is really going to be his downfall eventually. When it comes to Tommy getting out the game, I don't think he's ever going to get out the game. I think he's going to die in the game. I really do feel like that's what he wants to happen. Because he just don't know how to live without, doing some street stuff or whatever. But we get the episode starting off and he pissed off. Girl, they got Damon over there. Damon in the back. Sun rooftop. Linging in the scene with the gangster league. Go watch that episode tomorrow with the players ball. But anyway, listen, so you get all of that and he just in his feelings and all that stuff because he got shot up, you know, at least his car got shot up, and you know he already knows it's somebody from Janara's crew. But Diamond is like, I don't think it is, but you know, it's a possibility that it could be. And the only reason why he had a little doubt slightly is because he had already talked to Janara, you know, and so he also told him that this is what would happen. A war would pop off if you go out there and you do what you do to Chewy. Okay? And this is what's going to happen. He trying to tell him, you need to chill out. I'll go talk to Janard, you know. And Tommy was like, nah, I'll talk to him. I said, you know what, sir? Just let that man talk to his brother and you calm it down. But of course, Tommy don't listen. He goes over there and he talks to Janard, and you know, he basically like, I want the person who did this, because now there's a little girl that got killed. You can't control your people, and you know, basically if you don't give it up or whatever, I'm gonna get you. Anything and everything that Tommy or anybody says to Janard at this point, he tries to play big man in their face. But then once they walk away, he is shook to his core, because at this point in time, everybody knows that he's a weak link right now. They know that he's down men. They know that the men that he already got don't trust him. And, you know, they know that he really ain't got nothing and he's struggling at this point. And so Tommy coming over there, making him shake a little bit. But, you know, he gonna try to figure out what happened, because he did tell them to... He told them not to touch Tommy because they got to focus on getting this money. All right. What's more important right about now is paying off Miguel, is paying off the Serbs and all of that. A war is not in their game plan because they just can't afford to do so. They don't have the manpower. They don't have the money. But no, Lil K go out there and do what he did. And now he just started all this stuff. Meanwhile, Damon over there playing around with Miss Officer. Okay. And basically, then sweet talked her with some dick. Why I say it like that? To sell some drugs up into the other prison. Now, at first, she was trying to act like she was mad. So, you mean to tell me this is all that this is about? You up here doing all this stuff with me because, you know, you trying to get me to get some drugs up there in Salvaville? And he was like, I mean... In the beginning, it ain't really start off like that, but now I see the potential. But I'm just saying, listen, don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it. She was like, I'm just playing. I do it. I said, bitch, you are a bird. You are a bird. And truth be told, girl, I would have did it too. Girl, she trying to be on Love After Lockup, okay? Listen, she trying to be Jessica and Dustin. Now, if y'all don't know who that one is, that was the one who used to work at the prison. I think she was a nurse at the prison or something like that. And she wound up messing around with one of the inmates. And then once he got out, that motherfucker cheated. Girl, Dustin cheated on her. For my people that watch Love After Lockup, I'm telling you, he cheated on her. And how she know? Because she came in and he was in her bed with another bitch. I said, ain't this some shit? Mind you, he was only out for like 2-3 weeks. He back in jail now. Anyway, moving on from that. So then we get this thing where it's a little rally going on or whatever. And it's this little boy, Leon. We find out later that his name is Leon. He's 13 years old. And basically, he up there with Stacy from the, task force or whatever. And so at this point, I think they DEA. I think Stacy is DEA. But at this point, it's some other people up there, but they doing a rally or whatever for the little girl that got killed, right? They're trying to find her killer. And you know how this is just how it goes, especially out here. A child especially get killed. It's mostly when a child gets killed or injured or whatever by a stray bullet and all that stuff. They want to do little rallies. They want to do to clean up the streets and all that stuff. And sometimes it helps. Sometimes it don't. Because they be right back out there doing the same thing. But we see two different sides come together. We see the regular people there, right? Then we see Jannard and his crew show up. And we also see CBI crew show up. A couple of dudes from CBI crew. And then Jannard and a couple of his dudes, right? Mind you, he trying to figure out where Lil' K at. Okay? And so he want to know where he at. Once he find him, he going to take care and do the rest, all right? Lil' K hiding out at his grandmama's house. And right there, they find out that at that rally that they're going to do the task force. And it's a task force that's going to have three agencies together. The CPD, the FBI, and the DEA. I said, God damn. God, you might as well put the CIA up in that bitch too. Because, you know, since you're naming all the names and the letters and everything, the acronyms and everything. I said, what's next? All right. At one point, Jannard had went down there to Shanti's gym. That's the girl that he messing around with and trying to see about where Lil' K at. And, you know, she was like, I'm not finna tell you. We not finna do nothing or whatever because, you know, the crew is like, you got all this going on when you, this white boy coming through or whatever, doing all this havoc and you want me to snitch him out for him? Okay, when he was, y'all was supposed to take him out anyway. And I was like, girl, that ain't the point. The point of the matter is that was on the agenda. But baby, sometimes we got to move the plot points out of order and put it in a different sequence, okay? List the priorities, you know what I'm saying? And killing Tommy at this point is just not good for business. It's not good for image. And look at what happened. Chewy didn't kill that, Tommy didn't kill that boy, okay? Lil' K, he done took it upon himself to try to shoot and take Tommy out when he wasn't supposed to. And now you got all of the agencies all up on y'all. All on y'all. Knowing about CBI, knowing about treason, all of them. Okay? And so had he not been so gun hungry, had Tommy not been so gun hungry, and they just focused on doing the drug drops and stuff like that, it would have been fine. Meanwhile, speaking of this task force, they over there trying to figure out what's going on, right? Where is the CPD? Now, they said the CPD was supposed to be down here. We got DEA. We got FBI. Where is the CPD? Stacy like, don't worry about it. They on their way. I know they coming. Girl, who come up in there? Detective DeFranco. Girl, Detective DeFranco was like, yeah, I'm here. Stacy, let me talk to you outside right quick. I said, what's going on? He said, listen, bitch. Well, he wanted to say that, but he ain't say that. He had a little bit of respect and decorum because he up his side. He at work, okay? And I feel like he ain't the type of person, you know, that'll call a woman a bitch. You know, I just feel like that. He just gives off that vibe. I could be wrong. But he said, nah, you wanted this task force. You got the task force. And the only thing that I said was to leave me the fuck up out of it because it's going to mess up my job after all the stuff that you done did with the CPD, putting that civil lawsuit against them and all that stuff. Girl, I don't want to be involved in that. Okay, I still got to work at the CPD. But then you want to do this now? Okay, you put everything ahead of my job. You put your job ahead of my job, and you put it ahead of our marriage. I said, fast forward, rewind. I had to rewind because I literally thought he said my marriage. And I was about to say, damn, Stacy, you up here proudly being the side chick to this man. And she said, no, girl, that's my husband. I said, oh, so you willingly put your man up in this position. Now, usually I'd be like, you know what, F him, because reparations. But at the same time, I'm looking at DeFranco, and DeFranco don't look like he that bad of a guy. You know, he looked like he respectable. So I said, damn, girl, you can't just talk to the man, right? You put him in jeopardy like that? I just didn't like that, Stacy. Okay, you finna jeopardize your relationship. And he looked like he a good man to you, too. He looked like he a good man to you. And you gonna do that to him? Wow. Wow. Sneaky. Sneaky. You know, Tommy has to go over there to the crib. Get JP. Baby, what did I call him last week? Did I call him PJ? Get JP. We don't care. The brother with the deep voice. That nigga is an AI. Baby, do he got a voice box up in there? He just sounds like that is not his voice. Okay? But it's his voice, but it's just so damn deep. And Tommy had to come up in there and give him a gun. Okay? And little D-Mac, he just, baby, D-Mac want to be back out there in the streets or whatever. He want to be Mr. Big and Bad and everything. And I just want him to slow his bro, okay? Because at this point, is it winter? No. Is it at the end of fall? Okay, like, where is fall probably popping up? Is it at the end of summer? Because shouldn't D-Mac be up in somebody's school? Shouldn't D-Mac be up in somebody's school? I just want to know. You know what I'm saying? Mind you, you need to be sitting there making sure you don't get infected again. Your womb don't get infected again while you up here worried about having a gun of your own. Your daddy got it. He'll take care of it. Meanwhile, girl, did y'all see the part where Kate came down? Now, let me tell you this. Girl, Kate is really on this 12-step program trying to get clinked. Okay, she is really trying to get cleaned out there in these streets. You know, she said she came over there to the house. Tommy was like, Mama, I ain't got time for this right now. She was like, no, I need to talk to you. You know, make amends and all this stuff because this is a 12-step program. I'm at that step. And he was like, all right, go ahead. And she said, let me read this. Tommy, I am sorry for being a bad mother. I love you. Said that's it, because I'm sitting here like, because whenever I see people do the 12 step, they literally have a paragraph or two, okay, explaining everything that they did, what they really started for, crying and all that stuff. Kate said, my bad. Forgive me. I said, Kate, you gotta go sit down. I said, E for effort, okay? E for effort, because it's Kate. Girl, Tommy said, are you serious? You mean to tell me you ain't gonna tell me all the stuff that you did and you just gonna apologize for just that? Girl, if you don't, she said, you really think I was a bad mom? I said, now, Catherine, Katie girl, let's stop playing. You are a bad mother. I don't know how, if you is at your adult age doing drugs with your son, okay, encouraging the lifestyle that he leads, yes, you're a bad mother. So I can tell that you was a bad mother when you were younger, okay? Definitely. I said, now, Catherine, I know you're not asking this dumb question. He started saying, remember that time when I was 6 years old and you left me in the house for a week and I had to go break up into the neighbor's house just to go get something to eat? I said, what, Catherine? I said, you look like the type. And he started talking about something. When I wanted to go to Coney Island and I wanted to get some ice cream and you wouldn't do it. I said, what? Now you mad. Now you know you mad and you be holding on to stuff when you go back to a memory when it's talking about some food. Like, listen, I really wanted that corn dog, okay? You talking about some, why would you want some corn dog? Why would you want some? Just give it to me. I wanted to try it out. How would you know if I would have wanted it? That was when I was 7 years old and you would not get to me. And I never forgot that. I never forgot that. And it fucked me up so bad. That's how Tommy said that about that ice cream. I said, are you? You know what we heard? We get petty, okay? I said, now, Kate, E for effort, try it again. Girl, she done went and told PJ that she apologized for, you know, not being there for him and all that stuff. And he said, because at one point, D-Mac Darnell, he had asked the daddy why he wasn't there. Like, listen, why it took you so long to find me when it took me so little to find you? I had to fuck around and find you. And he was like, you know, it was a whole bunch of stuff that wasn't under my control. And, you know, I did try to find you and I just couldn't do it or whatever. girl, at this point, that's what Kay had said. Listen, JP, I just want to apologize to you because I'm at that step where I need to make amends. And he was like, go ahead, go ahead. And she was like, you know, I apologize for giving you away and not being there. I said, ma'am, when it comes to doing the bare minimum, Kate said, I'm going to give you the bare minimum. There is no directions and no instructions as to the length, okay? They didn't say 500 words or less, and if they did, I'm going to give you the less, okay? Girl said, that's just what it is. And he was like, you know what? That's cool and all, but let me ask you this question. So why did you give me away? Why wasn't you there for me? And she was like, I mean, I was young. I was like 14 years old. So what, Tommy, you was 16 when you had Tommy. You stayed there with him. It's because I'm black. I said, God damn, here we go. And she was like, oh my God, what, you think I'm a racist? I said, child, you may not have been, but your parents could have been. And that's what we later found out when she went to her 12-step program and she went to a meeting and she was talking how she'd been clean for 10 days or so. And, you know, the conversation that she had with PJ, and that just basically what it was. And she was crying. I really felt bad for Kate. I said, now, Kate, I don't know. Maybe sometimes what that say about me? Because I like messed up Kate. Because she caused a lot of drama. But this Kate is really trying to be a grandma. She was up in there making a cake for D-Mac and everything. I said, oh, my God. You know, when the grandkids come around, the parents want to change up a little bit. Sometimes, okay? And that is what happened with Kate. Maybe D-Mac is a good influence for the most part. But then again, D-Mac want to go out here and do his own thing. Because y'all saw when him and the daddy had the other conversation, right? And he let him know, you know, basically because of his sexuality, the ex-wife didn't really want him around the baby. Okay, and said, it's one thing that you're a black man, it's another thing that you gay, and I just don't think that that's what he need up in his life. And so that's part of the reason why he really wasn't around, or he couldn't find him, and she basically took the baby from him and all that stuff, whatever. And so it was just like, so son, I was just seeing if, well, you know, we can do it again, and, you know, we can give each other different chances and other, all of that. And he was like, I mean, yeah, I'm cool with that. And it was like, okay, so they hugged each other. He was like, I love you, man. He ain't say nothing else, but I noticed that D-Mac been calling him dad, you know. So I was like, wow, that's cute. Meanwhile, he go upstairs, this fool done took the gun out the freaking dresser drawer that's downstairs and put it in his waistband. I said, D-Mac, you done already got shot before. You just don't care, right? And your little homeboy, he up in there doing drugs with the CBI, you know, bagging the drugs and stuff. They put him up in condoms and stuff. I said, we don't put him up in balloons. Oh, I said, oh, the condoms probably got a little bit of lube on the outside. So that's probably what it is. And that, so that it can go up the ass a little bit easier, you know. That's what I'm assuming. Meanwhile, Tommy had hit up one of them or whatever. I guess they need some more product and all that stuff. Meanwhile, he also got he had a meeting with the Serbs. Not the Serbs, but he had a meeting with Walter Flint. Basically trying to get some information about who took out Liliana. Now, I don't even understand why he went over there to Walter as if Walter was going to tell him anything. Even if it wasn't his kid that did it, Walter was not going to tell him nothing. And at this point in time, I feel like it was just an intimidation factor just to let them know I'm still on the case. I'm not letting up until I find out what it is. Now, let me tell you something. I'm going to need Tommy to hurry up and take Walter out because we need a new person because Walter is getting on my nerves. Walter is up here fucking around with that man, Michael. Okay, that was supposed to get him that bad backs of drugs. Now, it's one thing to want to put bad, messed up drugs on the street that you already know is messed up and it's going to hurt a lot of people, right? It's another thing to want to put it in a specific place that the predominantly black and brown area, okay? Because that's what's happening over here on the south side. Black and brown, and probably mostly black. I'm not really sure, but I know it's a whole bunch of niggas and it's a whole bunch of brown Mexicans, okay? And a little bit of Puerto Rican sprinkled all up in there. So, you got that right. And then it was like, they had a meeting with Michael. And he was like, so we still going to do this? You know? And so, they exchanged the money for the drugs. Not even the drugs. For a drop-off point. Baby, give me. No, we going to have to give us at the same time. Okay? You give me, I give me. Okay? Because I don't want nothing to happen to my money. You know? Like, you get you, gotcha. Okay? Like, I'm going to be shit out of luck. And, of course, the daddy is doing all of this. Walter is doing all of this because he need money to give back to Dublin, right? He need that protection from Dublin. He owed Dublin, and he got to get this. Do you want to know who did this Dublin in this IRA, Ireland type of situation really, really good? Y'all got to go watch Sons of Anarchy. Because, baby, and that's where he come from. Walter Flynn, oh, that's where he come from. That was one of the first places I seen him. I said, oh, my God, you back in the IRA, huh? You just can't leave that life alone. He said, no, ma'am, I can't. Okay? Anyway, he got that, right? So they do the exchange, and it was like, you still going to put it on the south side? And it was like, yeah, we're going to still put it on the south side. And then Michael going to say, yeah, so them monkeys. I said, excuse me. And it was Victor that said, what you say? I said, oh, okay. You know, Victor, he feel like he black adjacent, but at the same time, he somewhat probably think he an ally a little bit just because he was messing around with a black woman. But at the same time, I was like, at least you spoke up. At least you spoke up. So I wasn't mad at him. I looked at Michael like, you gotta die. Because that word has been going around a little bit too much, and I'm so tired of it, okay? I'm pretty sure y'all was mad at the fact that that white man said that us black folks was monkeys, okay? But y'all weren't mad when that other girl said that to that other lady. Girl, let me shut up. Let me shut up. See? The hypocrisy, the contradiction. You see what I'm saying? Exactly. Moving on from that, I said, Victor, fix this, because he got to go. He got to go. Victor said, all right, bet. I said, all right, my nigga, go ahead, do what you got to do. Do what you got to do. Meanwhile, Diamond is up in his shop. This is the most action I've ever seen this shop actually do. Now, in the first season, I don't even think we seen two people up in the shop outside of Tommy and Diamond up in there. Now, the shop been full. Ever since they came back on for season two, it has been a working shop. He up there giving his parole officer a freaking trim and a cut. I said, ooh, I'll nick his ear for a little bit. But he cool, you know. And next thing you know, he even applied to him saying that he would like something like this and all this or whatever. And he got some hope that he'll be good and all that. I said, okay, Mr. Tyrone, you seem like you good peoples or whatever. But you on the straight and narrow. You don't take no shit. But you just look like you cool for right now. Girl, one of the dudes from the CBI niggas that was down there, you know, bagging up the drugs so that he can make the drop off at Stoneville at the prison. He come up. I said, oh my God. And it took the old man to be like, yo, when you come back, hurry on up back so you can sweep this floor up to make it seem like he's an employee. Okay, like he's going on a run, but he's an employee and he's family. I said, ooh, saved by the bell, you know, because the parole officer was looking. He was looking horrid. Meanwhile, Tommy and Diamond had got called over there to Miguel's, right? And I said, what you want with him? I said, y'all finna do a re-up already? Girl, not this moment. Miguel wanted them to come through so that he can show them what happened to people that betray him. And I said, who betrayed you? Because truth be told, Diamond and Tommy did betray you, but that he don't know. And he think that it was because of the drugs that went missing. And they thought that the serve did it. You know, this whole hit that Tommy and Diamond did last week. So he think that two of his boys, that they did it because they was the only ones that knew that where the drop was going to be. And they was like, please, Miguel, don't kill us. Don't kill us because we didn't do nothing. I said, they ain't do nothing. They ain't do nothing. I said, oh, shit, guess y'all did. Tommy was sitting back there, and the other one, the little young one with the hair, he the one that was talking about the drop, right? And they overheard it. Tommy overheard it. So he didn't know that. He didn't know that, Holmes. And I said, man, it was indirect, okay? Don't take him out like that. What you gonna do? Girl, it's a bucket of dry ice. It's a bucket of dry ice. Just floating in the air like it's the cauldron, okay? The witch's cauldron. I said, Miguel, what you about to do? Girl, Miguel said, watch this. I said, oh my God, what's happening? Baby, he took one of the dudes, he took the bald-headed dude hand, and he put it in there. That motherfucker said, oh, yeah. It reminded me of, have y'all ever seen the movie Mindhunters? Where Val Kilmer, LL Cool J is in there. The girl from Knox on the Moon from The Mummy 2, she in there too. You killed JT. Okay, and she was going with one of these FBI agents, right? They go into this little deserted town that where they were training at. And then all of a sudden, it was like a trap. And then as soon as the trap went off, the thing hit like this little oxygen tank or this nitrogen tank or whatever. Baby froze his legs up and them bitches just cracked. I said, oh my God. And I say that because that's exactly what happened to that man's hand. He pulled that hand up out that ice, that dry ice shit, nitrogen, nutrient, girl, whatever the fuck it was. And it was solid, solid as a rock. It looked like cemented, you know. And then Tommy was like, I mean, that's all cool or whatever, but what's this got to do with us? He said, I just want you to see what happens to people that betrayed me. I said, oh, you could have sent a video or something. We didn't have to waste our time to come up here or something like that. Girl, he said, here, get these plies. They put that thing around that man's arm right here on his wrist. And next thing you know, he took that hammer, a sledgehammer, bam, broke that bitch out. And I was just mad at the fact, because I'm sitting here thinking like, so the dude screaming like, oh my God. Because once you look at it, and I'm looking at it, I said, it looked like ain't no feeling up in that bitch no more, okay? Like, it's just dead. Like, it's frozen, all right? Like, you can't feel it. But the way he screamed it when he hit him, I was just like, oh my God, so did he really feel that shit? I said, oh, that's disgusting, and that hurts, all right? And they did that other boy there. Next thing you know, we just hear him screaming a lot. We don't see nothing else happen. I said, just take me out. If we're going to do all of that, just take me out, okay? I don't have time for that. I don't have time for that. I don't have no patience for freaking pain and all that stuff or whatever. Meanwhile, Claudia had came home, right? Her safe is open. Mind you, she live up in a penthouse in the sky. Who the hell else got access to come up in there? And that's a penthouse where you literally have to have a keypad or know the code or whatever to get up in there. And you got to get past the concierge, okay? And she was like, what the fuck? Girl, she come in and the freaking safe in the wall is open. All her jewelry, her money, probably even her pit still is gone. It is gone. And I said, child, this don't make no sense. She went over there to Dodge and she was like, what the fuck? And he was like, listen, bitch. This is what happens when you go against the family. You're going to get everything cut off. I cut your credit cards off. I cut this off and all that stuff. I said, damn. She said, I ain't no kid of her. I said, but you also taking his money. So, get out. And I was like, way to keep them in line. Way to keep them in line. Because Victor had told her, told the daddy, yeah, she was doing the Black Dahlia stuff. But, you know, since the formula got out, she put all her money and everything that she had up into it. And that ain't worth shit because the formula out there. I said, so basically, she backed up in the corner. She got to be on his side for right now. Or she got to play ball until she finds something else to do to get from underneath his clutches. It's crazy. Meanwhile, Tommy, Damon, he had a conversation with Tommy about the whole situation and saying that he figured out who killed Liliana. And it had to be Claudia. Because he noticed the words that Walter was saying. He was saying, my people and I protect mines and all this stuff. It was very possessive. And he said, you know what? When I went to talk to him, it's not like if, you know, and he said this to Walter. Because if it was one of your little crony dudes, you would have gave him up. Or you wouldn't have been protecting them so hard. But obviously, got to be your kid. And 9 out of 10s, I already know it's not Victor. It is Claudia. So, you know, Damon said, you got to make sure. Before you go do something else, you just got to make sure before you make a move. And she said, I mean, he said, you know what, I'm going to just go get it from the horse's mouth. Text her that we need to meet up. They do meet up. And basically, she lied. She lied. She had some people with her, too. And Tommy winds up tracking down old boy that was with her, one of the security guards, and was like, yo, what's up? He was like, what you doing here? I was like, I need you to tell me something. That night that Liliana got shot, you was there. You saw Claudia do it. And he was like, I don't know. And I ain't saying nothing. And he popped him in his knee. He said, now listen, all you got to do is tell the truth or I'm going to take your other good leg, okay? Did you see her? And he said, listen, I ain't see nothing. And if I did, I wouldn't say nothing. And he said, oh, being loyal to the end, and popped him in the head. I said, God damn, Tommy. Now you still ain't going to get the information that you need. Meanwhile, speaking about information, you got the drugs coming into the prison, right? That lady was sitting there in the waiting room talking to her man that was behind bars, right? She going to tell Miss Lady that Diamond was messing with and said, can I go to the bathroom? Mama was up in the bathroom for all of 30 seconds or less. I feel like it was 15. all of 15 seconds. I said, now, I didn't see Oz, okay? I didn't see 60 Days In. I didn't see a lot of stuff, and I know it take a little bit more to push that shit out your ass and to clean that bitch. And when she came out the bathroom 15 seconds later with a popcorn bag that she didn't put some... I said, they let y'all put popcorn up in there? Oh, okay. Y'all be having a movie night? Orange is the New Black. Girl, she put them dry-ass baggies of dope up in the popcorn bag. Now, I said, because it looked like popcorn, it camouflage. I was like, that shit is really dry. So you mean to tell me you pushed that out your cavity, your bodily cavity, you rinsed it off, you rinsed all of the bodily fluids and feces off, and you dragged it off in 15 seconds? All right, and then that motherfucker put that shit in his mouth. I said, that is nasty. Oh, I couldn't be one of them. Whew. Now, there's a lot of things I do, but that is one thing that I cannot. Gel ain't for me, and passing drugs through. Now, I can do that shit. I just, whew, Lord Jesus, I look at too much TV. I look at it like, oh my God, what if it busts inside me? I'd die. Girl, I got time for that, okay? I can never be a mule, you know? It just wouldn't work. Remember, like, you know what? Just take me out. The answer is always, just kill me, okay? Just lay me down, okay? Do what you got. Meanwhile, they doing the drug stuff while they taking out the, getting the food and all that stuff. This dude, Ramos, I think that's his name, he come through in a little wheelchair. He like, dumb ain't our stuff. And old boy that was pushing him was like, listen, CBI came through when they just got a lot of product up in here. They taking over, whatever. And so he was like, you know, you need to take care of that right now. But then Damon got word to old girl at the guard and had put Ramos in like this secluded place where they got the like the holes at and all that stuff, where they, you know, put him on 24-hour lockdown or whatever. And it was like, if you don't link up with CBI, I'm gonna put you down for, you know, selling drugs up in here, which gonna give you extra time, and then, you know, it's gonna send you over there to Pontiac, you know, and he don't wanna go there. So he in a lose-lose situation. And he don't want to work with CBI because Damon is the one that put him in the chair. You know, because he's in a wheelchair and Damon did that to him. I said, oh, all right. Understandable. But, you know, you're in a lose-lose situation at this point. So you might as well just hop on the train, all right? Meanwhile, look, hey, girl. DeFranco already figured out it was Lil' K, who it is. Then went over there to Lil' K, somebody went over there to his grandma's house. No, DeFranco went over there to his grandmama's house. The grandmama was up in there playing in her garden. Grandmama a G, okay? And a G in the sense of, I'm going to protect my baby through and through. I don't care what it is that he did, one thing about it, and two things for sure, I'm not finna give him up to the cops. I said, Grandma, do you know what he did? Grandma looked like she got down back in the day, okay? Grandma looked like she used to be packing back in the day. Mm-hmm. She looked like she probably was a Black Panther. I don't know. She just gives me that militant feel because she was 10 toes down, you know? And she was telling DeFranco, I don't know where he at, and this ain't nothing. You talking about some turning me in and you will help him and all that stuff. Girl, ain't no help out here for no Black boys, especially with y'all. I said, well, facts are facts, you know? And it was like, here, take your shit back. Girl, the boy was up in the window looking the whole time. Then he called him when he was outside the currency exchange when she was about to go cash her check. I said, Grandma don't believe in no banks. I get it. And so he was like trying to get him to flip. Not necessarily flip, but tell him what's going on. He was like, I ain't finna do all that. And so I was just like, oh, wow, you talking to the cops? He said, no, I'm not finna talk to the cop. And of course, Tommy was looking, mind you, Tommy found the car. Tommy then put a tracker on, I think, Jannard's shit when he went over there to his house. So he found out where Jannard was because he was looking for Lil' K, all that stuff. It was just a mess because Jannard winds up finding Lil' K and basically had a gun to him right outside his grandma's house. Grandma came down there with some Toll House cookies to stop the execution that could have happened because he was pissed off. And he was like, I told you not to do what you did. You know what I'm saying? And now a little girl done got hurt. And so it's just crazy. If it wasn't for the grandma coming down there with the cookies, Lil' K would have got killed right then and there. Meanwhile, you got Victor up in the car setting up the dude that was supposed to be dropping off the drugs for them, right? And so this was a way so that they can get their money back and all of this stuff and woo, woo, woo. Come to find out when Michael came through with all of that and was like, you know, we got a little problem because our guy got busted. They was like, okay, fine. That ain't got shit to do with us. Since you ain't got the product, give us our money back. Baby, before he can even give them or say, you know what, fuck it. I'm going ahead and give it to you, or I'm going to give you this discount or whatever. Victor then shot him and killed him. I said, damn, Vic ain't playing. Victor is not playing, okay? And of course, the daddy was not here for it because you just kind of messed some stuff up, you know? But Victor don't care. Victor don't care. Meanwhile, when it comes to, Damien had that little boy up in the shop. I think he was either doing his hair or whatever. But it feels like Damien's about to be a mentor to him. Because he was telling him, you know, keep doing what you're doing and all that stuff or whatever. It giving him encouraging words and all that. And his name is Leon. The one that was doing the talking at the rally for the girl that got killed. Mind you, he on his way. He turned the block for a half a second. And he got attacked by some boys, some neighborhood bullies. Just because they mad that he was talking about the neighborhood, about the fact that people be getting killed. I said, what are you mad for? You mad at the truth? What type of shit is that? That hood mentality right there, I just can't get with, okay? Right is right, wrong is wrong. And if you don't want that to be the narrative, you need not to be doing it out there. So basically, Diamond broke it up before anything can truly, truly happen. And I feel like he's going to be a mentor to him and try to get him into like some boxing or whatever. Because he was like, you got to learn how to defend yourself. If you're going to be out here doing all this, you're going to have to learn how to defend yourself. I said, all right, Diamond, we see you finna get a little bit of purpose. But what example are you setting when he trying to get y'all niggas off the street and you part of the niggas? Exactly. Moving on from that. Jannard, I'm going to need Jannard to just give it up. Jannard might as well just lay down and just say, Lord, take me now. Because at this point, this man is so stressed. You know how you stress to the point that even when you sleep and you get a full 8 hours, maybe 8 hours plus, you still wake up looking stressed and tired as hell like you only slept for two. That's how Jannard been looking this whole season. And we only on episode 3. Nigga ain't slept a good night of sleep that's worry-free in a while, okay? He driving down the street. The servant came through, pulled his ass over, and took his car because he ain't gave him the payment yet. And he was like, tell Rekovich, I'm good for it. I said, child, you better plead and beg. Next thing you know, Lil' K come pick him up. They in the car. He's sniffing. I said, now, is it coke or is it what? What is it? Girl, Lil' K said, I thought you said don't get high on your own supply. That's what I thought it was supposed to be. Bitch, at one point, he got upset at that, and something flipped him off, and he going at him. Next thing you know, I think he brought up the fact that he was talking to the cops and all that stuff, and he told him that, you know, they just let him go. He ain't say nothing. He was like, oh, it was just that easy. It was like, yeah, it was that easy. Next thing you know, Jannard trying to touch all over him to see if he wearing a wire. Mind you, Jannard is high as hell right about now. Because he took 2 bumps. I said, oh my God, Jannard, what are you about to do? Girl, he wound up strangling, choking that nigga out with the seatbelt. Then gonna go to another spot where somebody else was selling drugs to get some heroin after he dumped his body outside of the gate. And put a little garbage bag, a bag of garbage on top. I said, what? And of course, DeFranco found the body. I said, this don't make no sense, girl. Kay had got Tommy some ice cream. She got Tommy some ice cream. He was happy about that. That was cute. But this month, like I said, Jannard went up there and he went and got some heroin. Dude said, you want some cocaine? You want some heroin? Which one you want? He said, give me 2 bags. 2 bags of that H. I said, God damn, not the black tar. I honestly, and when he sat there, and first of all, the way he pulled up in that car, I'm thinking that this fool is finna go take it to the chop shop, get that thing stripped down, get it all of that because he ain't in his right mind right about now to dust off the fingerprints. No, he pulled up to another drug spot to get some heroin. Now, and mind you, he looked like he'd been rolling in the deep of the muds. I said, you look like a bum up in that car. Then when he get the heroin, he put it on his thing and he sniffed that mug. I said, wait a minute, you can sniff heroin like that? I know you can do cocaine like that and you can crush up opioids and do it like that. You can do H like that? Baby, I don't know nothing about drugs. I said, oh my God, that don't burn your nose. That don't burn, and it hit him real quick. Baby, I don't want no shit like that. Baby, sneak up on me. Don't hit me so fast that I ain't prepared. Like, damn, I know what's gonna happen, but goddamn, that's too fast, okay? I said, oh my God, Janar, you turning into a crackhead. Wow, this is what stress does to you. See, you should have stayed with Damon. You bit off more than you could chew. Meanwhile, you got Miguel and Damon over there with Tommy and Damon go over there to talk to Miguel. They trying to re-up. Miguel a little bit confused, and he probably a little suspicious because you got Janara having all these issues, but yeah, y'all ain't having issues like that. Y'all up here doubling up some more. And he told him, well, the reason why we need some more product constantly now because we got a new avenue. We up in the prison. And he was like, all right, I'm going to think about some things because Tommy wanted a little discount because he would, if we buy in bulk, give us a little discount. He was like, not now, but I think about it. Girl, at this point, Janard is just, whew, Lord have mercy. That man ain't going to make it. If he make it throughout the season, I'm going to be shocked. All right. But that is, what is this called? Power Book 4. Force. Okay. Y'all tell me how y'all feel about, why is it called Force? Because when I talk about Force, I think about the police. You know what I'm saying? And I know Tommy's supposed to be like a force to be working with, but I just don't connect that. You know, because I'm out here in Chicago. Chicago, we hear Force, we hear, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, y'all, let me know how y'all feel. I'll see y'all later. Peace.